Good morning children, welcome back to online classes. So in our last video we have learned question number 1 to 4 of this exercise. Now let us see the further question. Exercise number 1.4, page number 26. Let's see the question number 5. The temperature at 12 noon was 10 degrees Celsius above zero. The temperature was 10 degrees Celsius above zero at 12 noon. Okay, above zero is shown on the right side on the number line, and below zero is shown on the left side on the number line. So if it is decreased at the rate of 2 degrees Celsius per hour until midnight, so in 1 hour the temperature is reduced 2 degrees Celsius. Okay, so in 1 hour what will be the temperature? The temperature will be 8 degrees Celsius. Okay, again in 1 hour what will be the temperature? The temperature will be 6 degrees Celsius. Again in 1 hour the temperature will be 4 degrees Celsius. So like this, the reduction in the temperature is goes on till midnight. Okay, so you have asked now, at what time would the temperature be 8 degrees Celsius below zero? At what time the temperature will be 8 degrees Celsius below zero? Below zero means behind zero. It means to the left on of the zero. So what will be the temperature? At what time the temperature will be 8 degrees Celsius below zero, means minus 8 degrees Celsius, at what time? So let us see practically first, at what time the temperature will be minus 8 degrees Celsius. So in 1 hour the reduction in the temperature is 2 degrees Celsius, so in 1 hour the temperature will be 8. So in 2 hour the temperature will be 6. In 3 hour the temperature will be 4. In 4 hour the temperature will be 2. Okay, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Means in total 9 hours the temperature will be minus 8 degrees Celsius. This we have seen practically on the number line. Now let us see theoretically how to find out this answer. So the temperature decreased 2 degrees Celsius in each hour. Okay, so decrease in temperature 1 degree Celsius in half hour. So total reduction in the temperature 18 degrees Celsius. If you see from 10 to minus 8, there are total 18 degrees Celsius. Or total 18 degrees Celsius reduction in the temperature. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10 and this 8. This 10 and this 8 will be equals to 18. This total reduction in the temperature is 18 degrees Celsius. So 18 multiplied by half, because in half hour the reduction in the temperature is 1. So total half multiplied by 18 will be equals to 9. So it means total 9 hours, in 9 hours the temperature will reduce 18 degrees Celsius. Okay, so total time taken 12 noon plus 9. So at 12 noon the temperature was 10. Okay, at 12 noon the temperature was 10 degrees Celsius. So 12 plus 9. Okay, so what was the time at 10 degrees Celsius? At 10 degrees Celsius the total time was 12 noon. 12 noon means 12. Okay, so 12 plus 9 will be equals to 21 hours. 21 hours equals to 9 p.m. okay, so at 9 p.m. the temperature would be 8 degrees Celsius below zero. Below zero means minus 8 degrees Celsius. Got it? So do you have remember children the conversion of 12 hours clock into 24 hours clock, or 24 hour class clock into 12 hours clock? This we have done in 4th and 5th class only. So 1 hour equals to 1 a.m., 2 hours equals to 2 a.m., 3 hours equals to 3 a.m., 4 hours equals to 4 a.m. So like this, 21 hours equals to 9 p.m. So at 9 p.m. the temperature will be minus 8 degrees Celsius, or you can say 8 degrees Celsius below zero level. Now let us see the another one example. Now, question number 6. In a class test, plus 3 marks are given for every correct answer. Plus 3 marks was given for every correct answer and minus 2 marks are given for every incorrect answer. And no marks for attaining any question. Radhika scores 20 marks. If she has got 12 correct answers, how many marks has she attained incorrectly? How many questions has she attained incorrectly? Okay, let us see the first question first. So marks given for every correct answer is 3. So Radhika has attained 12 correct answers. So total score for 12 correct answers will be equals to 3 into 12 equals to 36 marks. So Radhika scored 36 marks for correct answer. बट राधिका टोटल स्कोर इज 20 मार्क्स. सो देयरफॉर मार्क्स ऑब्टेन फॉर इनकरेक्ट आंसर विल बी इक्वल्स टू 20 माइनस 36. इट मीन्स माइनस 16 मार्क्स वॉज शी स्कोर फॉर इनकरेक्ट आंसर. सो 16 मार्क्स शी स्कोर फॉर इनकरेक्ट आंसर. बट द मार्क्स इवन फॉर एवरी इनकरेक्ट आंसर इज माइनस 2. सो माइनस 16 डिवाइड बाई माइनस 2. ओके, टोटल स्कोर फॉर इनकरेक्ट डिवाइड बाई टोटल मार्क्स गिवन फॉर एवरी इनकरेक्ट. द टोटल स्कोर फॉर इनकरेक्ट आंसर इज माइनस 16. सो दिस विल बी डिवाइडेड बाई द टोटल स्कोर फॉर वन इनकरेक्ट आंसर. सो 16 डिवाइड बाई 2 इक्वल्स 8 एंड माइनस माइनस वी कैन पॉजिटिव. ओके, सो 8 मार्क्स शी गॉट फॉर इनकरेक्ट, सॉरी 8 क्वेश्चन शी हैज अटेन इनकरेक्टली. सो राधिका हैज अटेन 8 इनकरेक्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो मार्क गिवन फॉर 7 करेक्ट आंसर इज 7 into दिस इज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज मोहिनी स्कोर माइनस 5 मार्क्स इन दिस टेस्ट दो शी हैज गॉट 7 करेक्ट आंसर. सो फॉर 7 करेक्ट आंसर शी विल स्कोर 3 into 7 इक्वल्स टू 21 मार्क्स. बट मोहिनी स्कोर इज माइनस 5 मार्क्स. सो मार्क्स ऑब्टेन फॉर इनकरेक्ट आंसर इक्वल्स माइनस 5 माइनस 21. ओके, टोटल स्कोर माइनस टोटल मार्क्स शी गॉट फॉर करेक्ट आंसर. टोटल स्कोर माइनस टोटल मार्क्स शी गॉट फॉर करेक्ट आंसर. सो माइनस 5 माइनस 26 इक्वल्स टू माइनस, सॉरी माइनस 5 माइनस 21 इक्वल्स टू माइनस 26. सो मार्क्स गिवन फॉर वन इनकरेक्ट आंसर इज माइनस 2. सो माइनस 26 डिवाइड बाई माइनस 2. सो टोटल स्कोर फॉर इनकरेक्ट आंसर डिवाइडेड बाई टोटल मार्क्स फॉर every incorrect answer. So minus 26 divided by minus 2 equals 13. Okay, so Mohini has attained 13 incorrect question. Got it? Now let us see the another one question. An elevator descended into a mine shaft at the rate of 6 meter per minute. If the descendant start from 10 meter above the ground level, so how long will it take to reach minus 350 meter? Okay, the mine shaft started descending from 10 meter above the ground level. Do you know, children, the ground level means the zero level. Okay, so 10 meter above the zero level means 10 meter. Okay, so the mine shaft start descending from 10 meter above the ground level. So it was descended till minus 350 meter. Okay, below the ground level. And the rate of descending is 6 meter per minute, means in every 1 minute it was descended 6 meter. If the descendant start from 10 meter above the ground level, and how long it will take to reach minus 350 meter. So starting position of the mine shaft is 10 meter above the ground level, but it moves in opposite direction, so that travel the distance, so minus 350 meter below the ground level. So total distance covered by mine shaft 10 meter minus 350 meter. Starting position is 10 meter and the last position is minus 350 meter, reached till minus 350 meter. So let us count the total distance for total distance covered between these two points. So what we will do, 10 minus 350. Okay, 10 minus 350 will be equals to 360 meter. Okay, so total distance covered by mine shaft is 350 meter. So time taken to cover a distance 6 meter by it in 1 minute. So in 1 minute it covers 6 meter. So 1 meter is covered in 1/6 minute. Okay, 1 meter is covered in 1/6 minute. So total time taken to cover a distance 360 meter. So time taken to cover 1 meter multiplied by total distance. So time taken to cover 1 meter is 1/6. So 1/6 multiplied by 360. So 3 6 are 36. Okay, so 3 0 0 means if you divide 360 by 6 equals to 60 minutes, it means 1 hour. Okay, 60 minutes equals 1 hour. So in 1 hour the mine shaft reached minus 3 meter below the ground level. So I hope, children, you have understood this problem. Okay, so try to do by your own, look at the video carefully. Okay, try to get it understand. If you don't understand, ask me again and let me correct. There I would have said in 1 hour the mine shaft reached minus 3 minus below the ground level. So it was -350. Kindly noted. Okay. And if you won't understood, you can give a comment on the WhatsApp. Okay. But if you see the video twice, thrice, or four times, you will definitely get it understand. Thank you. Have a good day.